Who gets MS? Well, actually, that's quite a tricky question. There's a wide variety of people who have MS. For example, these people, they all have one thing in common, they have MS. I have MS too, and often I do think, why me? So what I've done is I've grilled Dr. Matt and Duddy to find out all the real facts, because he's a specialist. And he's also my specialist, and he knows all things about MS.
I'm Martin Duddy. I'm a consultant neurologist with a special interest in multiple sclerosis. I work at the Royal Victoria Infirmary in Newcastle-upon-Tyne in the UK.
What I really want to know is, are there many people like me?
So MS is a relatively common illness. If we look worldwide, we'd estimate there's about 2.5 million people affected by the disease. In the UK alone, it comes out, we think, at about 100,000 people. If you then start to look at children with MS, a recent estimate would suggest about 230 children with MS in the UK, and maybe just at the minute about 50 going through the diagnostic process at some point.
Wow, I didn't actually realise there was over 200 children with MS who were just like me. I've heard that MS is more common in different parts of the world. Why is that? It's a bit weird.
So where you find MS varies depending on where you are in the world. It's more common generally the further north or the further south you go from the equator, and less common in the warmer, sunnier places. A couple of theories as to why this may be, but I think now it seems to be probably due to vitamin D. That's a vitamin that is transformed in the skin on the effect of sunlight to become active. And it certainly seems to be in parts of the world where people have higher vitamin D levels that there's less MS. And in kind of cold, damp, cloudy places, MS is a bit more common.
So less sunlight means a higher risk of getting MS. You mentioned something about genes. Does that mean if my mum had it, would I get it?
People with MS have a genetic predisposition towards it. You often find it runs in families a little bit, and about 1 in 6 people with MS may have a relative affected by it. However, it's not a strictly genetic condition like more common genetic things you'd think of. So the risk would be, if you have MS, there's about a 2% chance that a child would be affected with MS, but that's still quite low and often happens quite late in life.
Okay, so genes are a part of it too, but what about infections and that? Can you catch it just like catching a cold?
So MS is not an infectious disease. You can't pass it on to someone else, but there is a very intriguing relationship between some viruses and MS. We know that if you have a viral infection, you're a bit more likely to have a relapse after it. So that seems to be one role. And if we look particularly at the Epstein-Barr virus, which is the virus that causes glandular fever, most people with MS, or perhaps even everyone with MS, if we look hard enough, as evidence that they've had an infection with that sometime in their lifetime.
Thank goodness for that then. So what you're saying is there's not really like one major cause of it.
There's no one cause for MS, and you probably need to have a couple of things happen, perhaps in a particular order, for any one individual to develop MS. A particular nice illustration of this is you can have an identical twin, and you might live in the same house, and one will get MS, and 2 out of 3 times the other one, same genes, same parents, same food, get away without it. So it seems to be an unlucky series of events that happens in one individual that makes it happen.
Thanks, Dr. Duddy. Here's some key facts you need to remember. There are approximately 2.5 million people in the world who have MS. It's more common in women than men. Of the 100,000 people in the UK with MS, around 230 of them are children. There isn't just one cause. Genes, germs, lack of sunlight, they all play a part in it, but to be honest, it's still really a mystery. But it's not anyone's fault. Like, if you or anyone in your family have got it, it's a thing that happens, but it's no one is to blame, so don't blame yourself or blame whoever's in it, who's ever got it in your family. You definitely don't have to go through this alone.